I want to sincerely thank the Senate for the unanimous passing of the bill at the Senate level. This bill, Senate Bill number 34 of 2018, was unanimously passed by our Senate. And by that, we appreciate that the Senate and Article 96 of the Constitution is truly the protector of devolution. But take note of the action by the National Assembly to stifle devolution that we as the county assemblies, we have taken note of the action by the National Assembly to stifle devolution and resolves to continue fighting for the establishment of the Ward Equitable Development Fund through the County Ward's Equitable Ward Development Bill number 34 of 2018, as passed by the Senate. If this approach proves impossible, which we doubt, because we expect the MPs to respond positively to the concerns of our people, CAF is keen to ensure the Building Bridges Initiative establishes the Ward Equitable Development Fund with not less than 30% of the annual county development budgets being allocated to the fund. And I think when we issued, as County Assemblies Forum, a statement in Mombasa last week, we categorically stated that the assemblies of this country will only look at BBI if most of the issues that affect Wajiko directly are taken care of. And one of them is the ward being identified as the primary unit of development in this country. Due to these devastating actions of the National Assembly, and further, the inability to attend to the constitutional requirement of gender equity in parliament, we are in concurrence with the advisory of the Chief Justice or to the President on dissolution of this parliament. We think it has lost direction and it has lost purpose. And as assemblies, we are appealing on the President to fast track the dissolution of the parliament so that Wajiko can have another chance to put responsible people in that August House. County assemblies of this country will actively, when the President sets the ball rolling, we are actively participating in the dissolution of the National Assembly, as its actions amount to going against Article 174 of the Constitution, and further, it goes against the will of the people who tirelessly and very early in the morning came out in large numbers to vote for them, and now they are wasting the aspirations of the people of this country.